Hi everybody, this is Mark Nugent, candidate for Irvine School Board 2016, coming at you live this Wednesday afternoon, 28 September 2016. Hi everybody, let me clean the screen real quick. So how's everybody doing today? So anyway, this is Mark Nugent, live here from Keller Williams Real Estate, hanging out, answering any questions you have live. If you're watching this in replay, go ahead and skip forward a couple minutes. The big reason why I do this is because you can fake photos, you can fake videos, make some video, you can even script a debate. However, you cannot fake live. So I'll be on for the next 20, 30 minutes answering questions live about the school district and get your thoughts. You can have my honest to goodness responses live, unfiltered and raw. This is a clean broadcast. I won't be cussing or anything like that. So if you have kids watching, it's not a big deal. So anyway, it is now 40 days, 18 hours, 4 minutes, and 43 seconds until the polls open. So until then, I'll be door knocking. So we can talk about some issues. We can talk about school safety and security. We can talk open, honest communication with the public, which is a big reason why I'm doing this. There is a huge lack, and there has been for a very long time, a lack of honest and open communication. A lot of people have been ignored, and a lot of people are upset. We talk about school overcrowding. Myself, I am displaced. My son is displaced. I have to drive like 40 minutes in the morning. And on top of that, there's no school bus system. And if I do want a school bus, I have to pay for it. So I'm talking about fiscal management. We can talk about avoiding centralization of power and keeping decision making at the local level. We should always do that. There's always, for some reason or another, some politician or somebody from federal to state to county to school even, or some like group that wants to centralize all the power decisions. Like, why? And also we can talk about recruitment and retention of quality teachers, because we all know happy teachers make happy kids. Kind of, I know it's common sense, but it needs to be said. Keep teachers happy. Happy teachers, happy kids. Happy kids, they learn and they're safe. So I think we've gotten so smart that we've forgotten the basics, and we have to go back to the basics. Unfortunate. But that's life. So I see a few people are watching, so give me a thumbs up, or you can ask a question. I will give you my response live. And I don't know who's watching, but more than welcome to ask me any questions about Irvine or the election, or even any comments if you guys have seen my signs. Also, that's another important topic. Here in Irvine, the lawn maintenance guys, they pull the signs up and they just leave them in a stack and they mow the lawns. I don't have all the time, and my volunteers don't have all the time always to go in and put the signs up. So if you want to see one of our signs laying down for somebody to mow the lawn, go ahead and stick it back up. Or if somebody else put a sign in front of it, if you guys could readjust the signs, it'd be a big help. So far, we have about 500 signs out. I think I'm going to get a few hundred more here next week. So if you guys want to help me put them out, that I'd be greatly appreciate that as well. So we can chat, we can see what's up. So anyway, nobody seems to be talking, so I'll just ramble on until you guys ask me questions. And tell me what you guys think of this live broadcast as well. Also, one thing I need to announce. I did release some military records. I released 2 awards and a letter from the U.S. ambassador I got. And I was kind of shy about releasing these awards because I felt it was kind of self-serving, and I didn't respect other veterans that made way more sacrifices than I did. But I decided, after advice of many and other many veterans, like, no, they told me, hey, you did what you did, and it's good. So why not release the awards and records? So, and I'll put up on Facebook. There was, quite proud of them. There's one that I like the best, is the letter from the U.S. ambassador. I'll read it if you guys want me to read it to you. And it's in my photos, so you guys can actually read the awards, and we can tell the stories about it. It was from a time when I was in Indonesia doing missions there for a few years. Yeah, about 3 years, 2009, 2011, so 2.5 years. And then I helped plan for 2012 mission. Anyway, I'm getting messages. So, anyway, some things we talked about. So, They say the worst thing you do in live broadcasting is just don't talk and stare at the screen. So also of note, I am the only one that live broadcasts. I don't know of any other candidate for, no other candidate for school board does. There are some that do that for city council. What's up? What's up, Joey? Let's look at the photos. So what's up? If you're watching us, say hi and go ahead and talk. All right. Oh, the other day I did do, I was on a TV show, by the way, if you guys saw that. So let's look at the photos and bring it up. So this one I can show. Here. This one means a lot to me. I'll tell you guys what it says. That was presented to me by the U.S. Embassy in Indonesia. And, for your professional expertise in military police force protection coordinator during the recent U.S. Army's bilateral Jeepoy Garuda Shield and with the Indonesian Army held in Bogor, Indonesia, 2011, the force protection provided significantly enhanced the security and safety for all participants, as well as solidified critical relationships with key Indonesian security forces. That was from U.S. Ambassador Scott Marshall. That one meant a lot to me. Though it's just a certificate, it's just a letter, but it meant a lot. The other ones I have are actually quite substantial, and it was an MSM. I got downgraded to ARCOM for heroic achievement. I feel weird saying that. I just did my job. It feels weird. But I don't know. You guys can read it. But it says there about thwarting a terrorist attack and et cetera, et cetera. And believe it or not, I was actually unarmed. And it was all just using the brain of just thinking about and critically thinking of what could go wrong and staying ahead of things. What happened was there was delivery made, there were some packages, and the guys had explosive traces all over them. And, took charge of the situation, found the guys, searched the packages, set up a new safety and security plan for the what was going on over there, without getting too much details. And then, after we left, the hotels we were staying at got blown up, and you didn't hear about it because no American soldiers died, because we were doing our jobs. So that's what you never hear about, but they credited me with many lives saved and protected, and I couldn't believe it when the general gave me that one. It's signed by, the award is signed by General Compton at Hawaii, and then I got another award on the same mission a couple years later, because they kind of put me in charge of the mission to do the safety and security planning along with a lot of other stuff for that mission, because that was just one piece of it. It was a big mission. And we have to go back like every few months and coordinate and meet with our counterparts over the few years I was on. And then she gave me another award, which my security plans were considered the gold standard for the Pacific region, which meant a lot as well. So I was a lieutenant. I was in the job, I think, of like a major or colonel. And I had to, coordinate with all these people, plan this huge event. And
hey, what's up, Jeff?
Hey, buddy.
Yeah, just live broadcasting. Did you see these things I posted? Did you read them?
I did not have a chance to read them, but I'm going to
read them. Read it.
I will.
It talks about thwarting the terrorist plan.
Okay.
It's pretty interesting.
Yeah, looking sharp, buddy.
Thank you.
Yeah. Good.
So this is Jeff Gibson.
I love all your signs out there.
You love it? We're going to order more.
Okay.
These are my new business cards, too, by the way. Like that.
Oh, I need one.
And one signs that, and one signs that.
That's perfect.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Perfect. Nobody's talking today. Usually people talk.
There you go.
In new cards. Well, there you go.
So, good stuff, my friend.
Yeah, I still got a lot more. I need to put more signs.
I like it.
I don't know. Like, people go kind of crazy with the signs. There's like a really a whole lot.
Yeah. Well, it's patriotic. Everyone wants to
You like that? You like that?
Yeah. Perfect.
Yeah, I'm going to, I think I'm going to expand the this and make the double font, because we made the logo like this, but then there's a lot of white space on my signs, if you noticed.
Right.
So make the bigger font in this Irvine School Board.
I think,
and
so, yeah.
And then eventually that'll say it's a good state.
Yes, it will.
So, all right, take care, Jeff.
Okay, good to see you. Okay.
Nobody's wanting to talk. What's up? You guys should comment. I got three people watching, but they're not talking. In the evening, get a lot of people watching Facebook Live. They're kind of chilling out after dinner.
Right.
Digesting, yeah.
Okay, let me know when you go on. Just text me, go on, and I'll come on.
Well, if you follow me, it should tell live. If you should go now and just sign up for live notifications. Should notify you.
You mean notifications I get on this thing? It's
just hard to keep track. You probably do get notifications.
I probably do, and I get so many. I just try to.
My phone's the same. I have to turn things off. But I'm gonna be broadcasting for another 15 minutes or so, and then I'm gonna go door knock.
Okay.
Putting out the yard signs in people's yards and talking to people. Actually,
perfect.
I'd like to the door knocking. It's actually not bad.
Not bad at all.
Yeah, it's.
I go put some short sleeves on though. It's hotter than heck outside.
That's okay.
Yeah,
I look good like this though. Long
sleeves. Yeah, you do. You look amazing.
And then you know people recognize this and they see the kids and stuff. So I give them this when I door knock. This guy actually he owns this company right here.
Yeah.
Tracy Pratchin, what's up? You're actually supposed to text, just like say hi. A lot of people just listen. They'll just sit up there. They'll be like cooking or cleaning or doing something, and they'll all just right. kind of put this in the background.
Oh, nice.
So I just like ramble on.
All right.
Tracy Pratchin, I actually went. I was like high school with her. I'm not sure about junior high. Remember, I was. Yeah, I remember grading her papers like in ninth grade English.
Oh wow.
Yeah, I just met her again 20 years later at their 20 year high school reunion. Yeah.
Cool. All right.
Yeah, that was actually.
I think I had a big class going on.
Is this bold?
I think so.
I'll show you guys what we're looking at. We're looking at class. Training tomorrow's real estate agents. Oh yeah, I do sell houses too. I haven't sold much lately because I've been focused on that campaign, but
I'll see you there, buddy. Okay. Take care. Great to see you.
Right. And if you need title, Jeff is the best title in Irvine. He's my go-to guy. So if I do, I'll go back to probably, I do like my 10% of my time is real estate right now. 90% is all election, just nonstop election, campaign. And just means that much to me. I've kind of put everything on my life on hold, and 12 to 18 hours a day I'm doing this. And I really wish that the other candidates, I know they don't have any much time, I wish they would. I wish they would do this, because this is an amazing way for the public to connect with their candidates. They can ask questions directly. They don't have to go to some debate or some forum or just read a biography online. You can actually talk to the people. Well, Stephen Chi Ying, I appreciate your comment. However, I don't talk about the federal election. But thank you for commenting. Appreciate that. But, you know, it's going to be one or the other, so we're going to be okay. But yeah, that's the one thing I don't talk about is the federal election. But I'll talk to you about the local election. And I guarantee you that the federal politicians will not be doing Facebook Live with you. I, however, will, because I am your neighbor. Do you live in Irvine? I'll let you type it up. But I do appreciate the comments. So I'll be on for another 15 minutes. So we can talk about some stuff. Common Core is another interesting topic people like to talk about. That's kind of, that splits the community. A lot of people don't like it. A lot of people do. So on and so forth. People don't like standardized testing. Because if you have a standardized brain, a standardized testing is okay. But the testing is not really something Irvine has a problem with. The kids of Irvine do very good at testing. And it's because of the demographic, like my family. My family's an Asian family, believe it or not. I grew up in an Asian household. And my wife is Filipino-Chinese. My son, I don't really see him as Asian. I see him as my son. But he is, I guess, technically, he's half Asian. He's half me. I just see him as my little boy. And he was on the other day. That's my little one right there. That's Maverick. There's my daughter. There's my son again. This is just a couple months ago over at CDC. And then, okay, this is the guy that owns this company I'm sitting at right now. There's the wife, you can kind of see. And then this is with Indonesian Special Forces. I put that on there because I had to learn how to speak Indonesian to do that mission. I had to build relationships with people that didn't want to work with me. But then I was able to make friends with them and speak their language. Right now, I kind of not study the Indonesian so much, but I'd like to learn how to speak Mandarin. I met Lily Wu yesterday. So I was going to say Wuxing Ba. I think Wuxing Ba. It's like I understand. So I'm learning a little bit of Mandarin. From what I understand is Mandarin is the national language. And there's also a large portion that speaks Cantonese. And again, if I'm wrong, I apologize. I'm still just trying to learn Chinese a little bit. I don't know if I'll be able to ever read Chinese, but I'll definitely be able to have a conversation. I just need to immerse myself, pick it up. I also speak German. I learned while in Germany, then Indonesian. And it's not that I'm like really smart in languages. I just like to talk to people. And I hate when I cannot talk to somebody. I hate not having communication. I hate communication barriers. And a language barrier is a barrier. I hate that. So I will learn that language. And I actually had a wonderful discussion with Lily. I was door knocking yesterday. I met Lily. And she was even texting me last night of how she can help the campaign, which was awesome. So
She was teaching me how to speak Chinese at her front lawn, so that was pretty cool. So I'll be door knocking that neighborhood again, probably here in the next 20 minutes. Here's another picture. I like this picture. Mike, I'll show you this one. This is us putting signs out. Isn't that cool? If you guys want to read the awards I'm talking about, okay. There you go. You can read these. Those are official awards. The only thing that is backed up my social up there. So, all right. That's some of the medals. This is the district. This is the headquarters of Irvine Unified. This is Bronca Parkway right here. I have like a bunch of signs in my little one. There's another one. Thank you for sharing my video. Appreciate it. A lot of yard signs. A lot of yard signs. Look at that. A lot of people. There's Eric Stevens right there. Awesome guy. There's Harvey's yard. So Eric Stevens, I sent him a mass email out, and he contacted me. He's one of my volunteers now. So the campaign just keeps growing and growing. There is me when I was playing a police officer the other day. I was on TV. That's the they're making a movie. That's me acting. Or not my, okay, hold on. This is acting. This is not. That's me on TV the other day. I was speaking publicly again and advocating again, like I always do. More signs on people's yards. Look at that. Just tons of signs of people's yards. Well, that's me when I was like 21. So here I am now, old. So I look pretty good for my age. And anyway, checking out. I got an awesome tan from door knocking and be outside so much. I really like that. Actually, I'm excited. I'm going to go door knock more of the Chinese area to learn more Chinese. I mean, ni hao. I need to, and then I'll learn more. I don't want to, I'm kind of embarrassed if I don't speak the words correctly. And, is Steven still there? Well, anyway, Steven, thank you for sharing my my feed. So I'll hang out for another 20 minutes, maybe 15 minutes. Let's talk about some other stuff. So transportation for displaced kids. If you're my son got displaced. There's too many kindergartners. And again, we're in the second year being displaced. We're now at we're supposed to be in Woodbury Elementary. I'm not gonna say what elementary he is in because that's a safety thing. But it's a pain. I have to drive him 45 minutes round trip. I gotta get in the car, drive the other side of the city, get him into school, wait there, you know, and I make sure, you know, he gets his class safe and everything, and then I can go about my day. And to go back to the house, I want to work out of the house, takes me a while. Versus Woodbury, I live like right next to Woodbury Elementary. I should just be able to walk him to school. I wouldn't even bother driving. It's like right there, it'd be 10 minutes. So and I'm not the only family in that situation. So, and I know that the district, we do at least two facility studies every year. Sorry, someone just texted me. I was just texting somebody, just messaged me. So anyway, that's what's going on with the campaign. I'm gonna show you guys this. I'm gonna show you one thing, okay? And this is I like this photo because it was one of my good friends, Chaplain Mike Landers. However, I don't like it because he's taller than me, and I'm actually standing like in a hill. I actually had to tilt. I had to tilt the camera. So let me show you guys. So he's actually extremely tall. Me, I'm like 6 feet tall. I'm like built like a linebacker, right? I'm like 236 foot tall. I'm actually standing on an incline, and he is like 6 foot three. So here I look like I'm 5 foot four, but reality, I am actually pretty tall. I was like, should I post this? It makes me look short, but I was like, it was okay. This is one of my good friends, Mike Landers, and he endorsed me as well. He's actually from Irvine, but we served together out of a Hawaii-based unit in the military. So anyway. And if you're just joining me, I'll talk about this. For the last year, I was engaging and trying to work with the district to advocate for them to fix safety issues and needs for, and issues, especially safety issues for special needs kids, which is an issue. We were, me and Christina, she has a 5-year-old autistic child. We want hedges grown, simple 3-foot hedges. How easy is that? Over one part of the school that has fast moving traffic, because her son will run out in front of traffic. And I know there's a lot of special needs parents. And actually,
what's up, Dan?
I actually have an appointment tomorrow with the special needs director of Irvine. And one of the issues is special needs is forgotten about.
And no, we don't forget about anyone. We're supposed to take care of them and fight for them and not just quit. I see a lot of quitting and I don't like it. I see lack of communication, like people getting ignored and just people just getting lazy. I'm like, no, man, we got to fight for those kids. Fight always. I will fight for the parents, especially if parents are struggling. They don't know who to talk to. They don't know. They just give up. We never give up. We always fight. We push forward. We're going to fight with the state and get more funding. You better believe it. The LCFF. Hi, Brian Yang. How are you doing? The LCFF. And then also, I was talking to Lily Wu, and through a translator, you know, there are issues in the trans community as well. Uh-oh, someone just messaged me.
But anything else you guys need, feel free to just call me up. I want to be here 411, so call me up. I'll find the answers for you guys.
So.
What's that?
Sorry about that.
Get that information for you guys.
Excuse me, sorry. So anyway, into reaching into the Mandarin community, there are issues that, because of a language barrier, are not addressed. And I am married to a Filipino-Chinese person, and I have lived in Hawaii. I have commanded a military unit that had 90% Asians, and I understand the culture is not to speak up. They're very humble, very, very polite people, and very nice. So that we, I say we because I grew up in an Asian household.
On what's hot, what's not.
And I'm sorry, someone's messaging me.
That sort of thing.
So I grew up in an Asian household. You're kind of soft-spoken, and they don't know who, they just kind of go along to get along. But even my wife, you know, she's like that. And my wife being part of that demographic also cares a lot about academics. You know, she says, you know, 4.0 grade average isn't good enough. We need a 5.0. You know, she's always making sure my son is doing homework and doing good grades. So, and I'm okay with that. Of course, usually Monday nights when we get his homework, we all sit together as a family and we do the homework. Because if I don't sit down there with my son, he'll be like, Dad gets to sit around and watch TV. Like, I do my homework? No. And no, we all have to sit down and do his homework. Which, it's fun. It's a weekly ritual. And again, that's, I will tell you guys a little more about myself. You know, I am in the military. I missed a lot of my daughter's life because being in military service, I wasn't there. I was gone, deployed, or moving around, or whatever. And, you know, one of the reasons I'm going to be here for my, you know, be here for the younger one, I don't want to miss anymore. My daughter's 13. I'm going to be there for her high school years. She's moving back with us full time, which is great. And then my son, I'm going to be there his whole life. So that's really cool. And I have opened up my photos of my family, which for me is kind of scary a little bit. But I'd made the decision to be a public figure and to put my information out there. So. Anyway, hope you guys enjoy the videos. I do get a lot of positive feedback. Excuse me. Sorry. So anyway, we still be going in person watching live, so feel free to comment. Anyhow, Brian Yang. And I'll be meeting Lily Wu again, so she says she's going to teach me how to speak Chinese. I do believe the 15th or 16th, oh, thank you for a thumbs up. With the 15th or 16th time March says your website and listening to your live now. Well, thank you, Brian. I hope you vote for me. And where are you from? Did you grow up in Irvine? Are you Chinese? Like my family is, my wife is Filipino Chinese. And then my stepfather is Filipino. My brothers and sisters are Filipino Korean. I know it's kind of weird. I know I have blue eyes. I know I'm white guy. But I was raised in an Asian family, which most people find interesting. Actually, I'm very comfortable in the Asian Pacific community. When I was in the Hawaii Reserve unit, I commanded a unit of all Asian descent. It was great. I had about at least half Filipino, and I speak more Filipino than they do, which is hilarious because they grew up there, you know. But once they saw my wife is, you know, Filipino, I don't live in Irvine now. Okay, cool. No worries. Well, you're always welcome to come back, right? Irvine, by the way, is the fastest growing district in the state. We are building a couple new elementary schools. I have all the information right here. We actually met at the district the other day. Yeah, I'm kind of excited about this election. And to everyone else that maybe is kind of nervous about what I'm doing that works the district or is getting elected, no matter what happens in November, I'm not going to stop. I'm still going to advocate for special needs kids. I'm still going to advocate for the safety of the schools. I'm not going to be ignored. I will still fight. I will still publicly speak. I will still make change happen, positive change. I've met too many people. Yeah, well, thank you. Awesome. Tell them to vote for me. I've met too many good people. You know, I go back to my first intent when I started getting engaged September was I just really wanted to volunteer my time because I have expertise in safety and security. That's my background, as seen in my awards. Yes. Go ahead, Brian. My military awards, you can see online. The award for heroic achievement, the commendation from the U.S. ambassador to Indonesia, the letter, it's all on my Facebook. So I just wanted to do a couple hours a week starting a year ago. That's all I wanted to do. But then I started finding these issues and I started getting ignored. It took me till like from September to January to get an appointment. Really? I had 6 months, how many months, 5 months? Late January, February? Before they even, and then even then, they just think, oh, well, he'll go away. I'm like, no. I mean, maybe I have a gripe about something I don't know anything about, sure, right? But when you're specifically talking about something that I have most expertise in my whole career, I can't stop. Then I start meeting all these parents, like Christina Vu. Her poor kid, he's autistic because of, you know, his life's in danger. All they need to do is build a 3-foot little shrubs, like bushes, and that's it. The kid will be really safe because there's like this fast-moving traffic. It's not that hard, and the parents want walls. Like, I talked to like 100 parents in the school. They want big walls and all that stuff. I'm like, well, first off, we have traffic safety issues, so let's just put a 3-foot little hedges to keep the kid from running in front of the street. Because he's autistic, he's very healthy, but his mind, he won't listen. And the mom's terrified. And I spoke publicly for her, and I will continue to. And again, I'm meeting tomorrow. I'm meeting the special needs director, which she sounds very unhappy that special needs is forgotten about. I'm not going to read her words, but I'm just going to give you kind of a vibe. So I'm going to assist them. Those are the two things I feel very passionate about. And I will speak out for those who speak out for themselves. I always will. You aren't. Cool, I just got a message from another teacher. I actually have teachers helping me in my campaign that unfortunately because of their jobs, they cannot say who they are. I have one openly, she didn't care. She's like, I'm supporting you. She's putting out signs. Her name is Mary. And she'll pop in here later. She's awesome. And she's a teacher here in Irvine. I have another one, an educational director supporting me and helping my campaign behind the scenes. Her name can't be used because she's not allowed to be political. It's unfortunate. But so it's not what you think. And then we had the issue the other day. A little kid got denied food. What's up with that? I just keep turning these little rocks. I'm like, what's going on here? So I got to find out the stuff and do read more about these. Sorry, I'm looking at this book. They gave us, it says board candidates orientation. I know it's backwards, but it says board candidates orientation. Last September 22nd, last week, we had the superintendent and the senior staff actually briefed all the candidates, which was really good information. And we got to sit there and ask questions. We got this. Look how big the budget. I got to learn the budget. So we got briefed. I've been through lots of budget briefings in Irvine Unified through the public meetings. And then the assistant superintendent, Mr. Fogarty, he's actually quite intelligent, very smart guy. He does the budget briefings. If you ever want to know about budget in Irvine, talk to Mr. Fogarty. Hands down, the expert. He'll tell you every little line by line. Brilliant guy. And he'll explain it all to you. So he gave us a brief. We had this. We got to ask all the heads for 2 hours about the district, which was awesome. We also, some things I didn't like when I sat in there, things I would like to change. Nothing personal, just professional things, some shift. And this whole thing, I just want to say straight, I don't badmouth the other candidates and everyone. Well, actually, a couple of them I actually really like, but I have to keep myself from actually saying more positive things about them because I want you guys to vote for me, right? However, even if you don't, I'm still not gonna stop. I'm still gonna do what I can. The two things I'm gonna definitely, safety and security, I'm not gonna stop that. I will advocate for special needs and any other parent that's in need that does not know where to go, does not have this intimate information that over the last year I've accumulated. I know all the players. I know the system. And telling you, the system is not much different than the military. The Irvine Unified School District is structured very, very similar as to a U.S. military brigade headquarters. It's very similar. And you can compare, like, schools to, like, a battalion level. It's very similar. So it's really easy for me to navigate and know how it all works. I know how people act. I know how people work. So some people are going to ask me, what is your experience in the military? How does it relate? Well, it's still people. It's still big, huge moving chunks of government and people. Uniform or not, it's just people. Big chunks of people moving and large executive level decisions. So anyway, back to special needs. So I asked the question, what resources do we have in the district for special needs? And it was towards the end of the brief, and they were retired. It was already late. And they told me we have full spectrum services for special needs. And then I looked at this later on that night. I looked in here, and one of the programs that were underfunded are the special needs. So that I've got to go lobby and go advocate for more funds from the state. Hi, Kimberly Nguyen. How are you? Welcome. So anyway, we're just talking about special needs, and I'm going to go work with the assistant superintendent and the state to get sustainable funding in the LCFF for special needs because they're underfunded. And believe it or not, when we underfund special needs, actually putting kids at risk in their safety. There's also issues with kids that are left on the wayside because the district tends to focus on people that are going to Harvard and things like that. So they're all the ones that slip through the cracks. I'm going to tell you right now, I was one of those kids. And, you know, I didn't get good grades in school. You know, I was a very poor welfare family and just kind of forgotten about and thrown away. At 16, I was on my own. And, you know, there was some nice teachers that helped me. One principal, she helped me, and some of the high school teachers helped me get into the military. So at 17, I had life. That was 20 years ago. This time 20 years ago, I was just about to graduate basic training and go to jump school. And I went to the 82nd Airborne and jumping on airplanes. Not too long after that, I deployed for the first time. That was interesting as well. So anyway, I really appreciate those teachers. And actually, Mr. French, one of my teachers through junior high and high school, he actually wrote me an endorsement. He's now a principal, and he wrote me an endorsement. He has a photo of me and an email and a story about me at his front office. So his kids that aren't doing so great, the at-risk kids, can say, hey, this was a story of a guy that did something good. So anyway, let's talk on. I also want to focus on teachers, you know, retaining teachers, quality teachers. The average salary for a teacher is about $75,000. And again, that's enough. Some, you know, I think they start about $60,000, probably go to $90,000s and stuff. And for Irvine, that isn't that much money. I mean, it's okay, I guess, right? It's pretty good. But again, people don't keep their jobs just for the money. It's the intrinsic reward that teachers have, and we need to appreciate them. We need to celebrate teachers. We really do. They do a lot. So I'm definitely an advocate for the teachers. And as aggressive as I am at protecting the kids, I'll protect teachers. Happy teachers equal happy kids. Easy. Easy, right? Happy teachers, happy kids. That's it. You better believe I'm going to be protecting those teachers that protect my little ones. I've never bothered a teacher in my son's school. I'm always really nice to them. I always ask them, is there anything I could do for you guys? Always, always. And that's about it. I've liked all my kids' teachers. They're actually always really nice people. And I'm always like, what can I do for you? And they're like, oh, they look at me like I can't do anything to help them. I'm like, oh, I will. They learn now. They're like, wow, this guy's an advocate for us. He'll fight for us. And a lot of them are just anonymity. They can't speak up because they're worried about losing their job, which is horrible. They're like, oh, don't tell the principal. I'm like, what? That's messed up. So I figured the system out very quickly. And here I am. I think I'll get elected for a lot of reasons without going too much into detail. Let's focus on the issues. It's not really about me. It's about the problems and finding solutions. And again, we are going to find solutions because whoever's elected, me or not, I will still be in the fight for the next 11 years. I tell them every time I brief them. Last year, I was like, hey, my son's in kindergarten. You only got to deal with me for 12 more years. And they all laughed. And I was like, wow, I didn't think you were going to laugh because I'm being very serious here. Now I've got, I always tell them, I got 11 years left. Let's fix things, okay? And I can actually can bring a lot of other resources in. I have a lot of knowledge of the way government works and the way people works. So we also talk about charter schools, if you guys like to talk about charter schools. That's also a sensitive subject for the district. We don't have a charter school. Talk about free breakfast and lunches. Someone yesterday told me they would like to see free lunches for the kids in the summertime as well. I think that's kind of a cool program. You know, you could feed kids. I mean, that's very quantifiable because some of these kids that don't have any lunches, they're not well off. They're actually free and reduced lunches. What are they doing in the summertime to get that meal? I have a memory of me and my brother fighting over food when I was little. That was horrible. It sucks. I tell you, it sucks. I didn't want to think about that memory. So someone said, look at the possible way to feed the kids during the summertime. I think that's kind of cool. You know, if we can afford $1 million bombs, we can afford some $2 corn dogs for the kids in the summertime, right? And definitely going to focus this whole thing on relationship building. We have an issue with relationship building. We have some very entrenched systems. We got to, you know, change things up for the positive. So anyway, Kimberly Nguyen, you can chat if you want. If you're still there, you can chat. I'd like to know where you're from, what's your heritage, etc. Mine, I grew up here, and I have two children. My wife is from the Philippines. She's Filipino-Chinese. She came over here when she was 25 years old. She is a nurse. She works at Kaiser over at Alton Sand Canyon. I know, Filipino nurse, right? Go figure. It's a little bit of a cliche. But she came over to the United States as an immigrant, and was she 25? So that's a while ago. And then I'm not going to say any ages. And she became a nurse. I worked at Kaiser in Hawaii, and then we met at the mall. We met over at Nordstrom, actually, in the mall at Ala Moana Mall, the big one, the big tourist mall. We met there. We started dating, a very normal relationship. And I actually asked her to marry me in front of about 500 people, and the governor of Hawaii was there. It was in, was it 2008? February 2008 or 2009? 2008, I believe it was. I forget the date. I should remember that, right? Anyway, I asked her that we was a military ball, and I got to talk to Lizelle Moto. She has the video, and we had it all planned out. It was right after the last little thing. They retired the colors, like they put the flags away. It was a military event, and I had it set up where they gave me the microphone, and I had this little note, because I have books like this, little note like this. I was so nervous, and they gave me the microphone. I just looked at those lines. I remember reading them, and I proposed to her in front of big audience, and that was nerve-wracking. And a lot of people remembered that. They're like, wow, that was bold. I'm glad she said yes, because it would be embarrassing if she said no. Well, she could have also said yes and just later on changed her mind, but she didn't. Now she's stuck with me. And it's funny is one of the questions I got asked by people endorsing me was, how do you plan to engage with the Asian population in Irvine? And I said, well, I'm married into it. So, shameless plug, yes, I am married to Asian, a beautiful Asian woman. But again, I don't think of her as Asian. I think she's a poor woman that stuck with me, lived with me. And then again, my son is half Asian, but I don't think of him as half Asian. I think of him as my little boy. And should I miss him already? I'm always worried about him when he's at school because I have the safety issues. Hey, Kimberly, how you doing? You guys should chat. Please talk. I will do this for another maybe 10, 15 minutes, and then I'm gonna go back to campaigning, knocking on doors. Why'd the music stop? Get some music going. Sorry, I got the sniffles for some reason. I apologize. Some people commented on that. Don't sniffle in your videos. It's live, right? This isn't scripted. So Kimbo, if you're still there, why don't you ask some questions or something? Let's have a conversation. Usually in the evenings, we'll have a good 10, 15 people here join us. And I actually love live. I think this is a great way to connect with the public. And you guys can just ask me directly what I think about something. and get an honest-to-goodness answer, because we know you cannot fake life. You get a question, you'll see facial expressions like, if he's making something up or if he's lying, you know you'll get the truth instantly when you're talking to somebody. And how cool is that? Also, one of these days, I got to get Mayor Mike Munzing back on here. I did interview Mike Munzing a few months back, and hopefully I'll get him on again here. I used to do a lot of Periscope. Unfortunately, that is too global of an audience, and now I'm focusing more local here in Irvine and Orange County, so I'm doing more of this. And again, you got trolls there. Hey, Angela Beaton, how are you? So where are you from, Angela? I'm going to leave you a thumbs up on your comment. So Angela, where are you from? Are you in Irvine? Sorry. Okay, well, I'll give you a second. You may just be listening or driving, which is cool. I know some people just, they'll maybe listen and drive, which is cool. So, anyway, if you're just joining us, some of the issues I brought up was lack of transportation for the district. Again, that's a resource. We've got to fight with the LCF to get the LCFF fully funded. Ontario, Canada. Well, we're on a fence listening to Ontario, Canada. What is up? You know what? Canada leads the world in being just north of America, or just north of the United States. But it's a very cold place. I used to live near Ontario, California, which is just down the road. Did you guys know that we are experiencing a national teacher shortage? However, not in Irvine, not yet. And we need to keep it that way, which is not only pay them well, but happy teachers. I'm talking about teachers treated with respect and dignity. I have not heard that yet. All I've heard is make teachers do more. And I'm like, no. Let's treat them with dignity, self-respect, and respect and dignity. Everyone needs that at work and be listened to. Because I know that sometimes the teachers are ignored. I have a good friend of mine, he's a teacher in Georgia. And I'm not going to mention his name because he hates politics. But he says districts don't listen to teachers. They just don't. And that's messed up. They listen to parents before they listen to teachers. Which they should listen to both. Don't you guys agree? They should listen to teachers and parents. They should listen to everybody. There should be communication. And if I absolutely love communicating with people, that's why I like to learn other languages, because I hate communication barriers. And if you guys know anything about me, if you go to like a social event, you see me there, I will sit and talk to you for as long as you need to get your point across. If you're a parent, if you're a teacher, I'll sit there and listen to you. Some of you guys know this, you've met me. I'll sit there, I'll talk to you, I'll let you talk. And oftentimes people become friends with me, they support the campaign, and we're better off for it. But when we ignore people, it's not gonna end well. And unfortunately, it happens. And it happens if people get comfortable with their positions or they have personal issues. And again, I don't know any of the candidates really other well. I have no personal issues with anyone from the district. Nothing personal at all. Yes, vote for Mark. Thank you. Share the feed. Get more people in here. Share. I'll stand as long as you guys need. So, again, I apologize. I have the sniffles. So, open and honest communication. I lost my train of thought there, but, you know, you'll get, I'm sorry, okay, there we are. We get people get comfortable. They have personal issues. They fight. And this is a place like any place in a city where people have known each other for a very long time. They've known politicians, have known each other for 10, 15 years, and they fight and they argue. It's just like the military and like the reserve units. That's what it is. Active duty, you got people moving around all the time. But in reserve units, they tend to like stay there. So there's this deep-rooted hatred and these connections. You don't know who knows who. Me, I'm totally neutral coming into this. I have no personal issues at all. A matter of fact, I still have not had a personal conversation, a conversation with any of the board members. I've said, just recently, I finally said hello to one of them. The superintendent finally shook my hand for the first time. Yes, the first time at the orientation, the candidates orientation. I've spoke to the board, I don't like 6, 8, 9 times. I spoke publicly. You tell me, what do you think? That's funny. That's funny to me. He shook my hand for the first time, the superintendent. They greeted me. That's it. I've never had a conversation with them. So there's no personal feelings. professionally, I have some disagreements, so I'll put that out there. And I will not engage in any negative campaigning. And there's a couple people I really do actually like on a personal level. But there's nothing I have any negative. It's all in the happy, positive things. And I want to, you know, advocate and help everybody while engaging. I want to build relationships and break down barriers and get the things that we need done. That's why I'm doing this. I was thinking, why am I doing this? What is it for? And again, it all started September. And just when you ignore somebody, hoping to go away, sometimes you end up with someone just running against you. Chances are, if they just called me, I'd probably be helping their campaigns. But I know people get busy, but we cannot ignore parents. We cannot ignore teachers, not ignore the kids. If it's inconvenient or you're tired, it doesn't matter. It's your job. You got to take care of these people. That's the thing about me is I'm younger. I have this energy. I have that drive. And sometimes you got to put some new people in there to get some energy and get some momentum, some moving forward. And there's just a lot of frustration right now in the community. I've literally talked to thousands of people, door knock. As soon as I get off here, I'll be door knocking from the 4 or 5 hours, probably to 7 p.m. tonight. Probably stop for 20 minutes, get a quick bite to eat, carry some water with me. And talk more people. The good is I've actually lost some weight, so I'm looking a little thinner. I got a tan. I look all nice and some brown now. Canadians vote for you. No, I am only people that live in this city can vote for me, but you can like and share my feed and help me out. You can donate to my campaign if you want to donate money. I do need money. I admit it. I need some campaign donations. I have put up 500 of these signs. Each sign, I have big signs that go on like the side of the road. I'll show you. Here, like these signs. Here's my son. I'll show you, Angela. There's my little one. So these signs that go on the side of the road here to tell people to vote for me, has all my information. It's like $5 each. So I need to buy another 300 of them. I have 500 so far. And unfortunately, this looks a little small right here from far away. So I'm gonna double this, have the artist double the size of that and then make the website a little bigger. You guys can donate at the website or you can go to my Facebook page and there's a donate button. But you can do that. If you're not comfortable with that, just share the feed. Get people here. Talk to people in Irvine. Say, hey, vote for this guy. He's decent. He's a good human being. You know? And there's an intrinsic... You know, and the reason why I do this, you know why I do this? And why I'm trying so hard? It's not only for my son. It's the intrinsic value I get from helping others. I know people that are millionaires. There's people walking around right now that are multi-millionaires. And the money doesn't necessarily make you fulfilled. Helping my neighbors, my friends, Christina, her son, that will be fulfilling, knowing that family appreciates what I did to keep their kids safe. That will mean a lot to me. So that's why I do this. That's a good soundbite, but yeah, that's why. It's honestly why. I was at knocking on someone's door the other day, and she started talking about this guy, Harvey, that I know. And he's like an activist, and he has a newspaper, and he does all this stuff, and he believes in strongly. And she's like, man, he's a good guy, but why does he do it? He's like 70, and he's still out there, and he's working hard, and he could retire, he's got money. And I told her, who does this? This is crazy, too. Why? And it's because the intrinsic rewards. That's why. And that's why teachers teach kids, because it makes them feel good. So we have to take care of them. And I want to definitely fight for the teachers. So, and I really thank all the teachers that have helped me so far. I have teachers helping me, which is amazing, because I used to talk, when I was like 7, I was such a bad kid. It wasn't bad, I was just being a kid, and from a broken home with not a dad around. So it was a struggle. So not a lot of positive role models to support you there and help at your homework when I was a little one, just kind of on my own. And then, that brings my next point of second chances. Keep pushing, brother. Send you pause. Thank you, Manuel. That's right. You're my friend Mike's little brother. What is up? Tell Mike I said what's up. I miss that guy. And, man, if he was my high school teacher, Mike Sandoval, I'd be scared. Manuel Amaya, he's a younger brother of my friend, Mike Sandoval. And Mike Sandoval, I'm not going to cuss, but he's just a badass. He's a badass. He's awesome. He did way more tours than I ever did. He did way more. He was an infantry guy, frontline fighter, multiple tours, multiple. And the stuff he told me, wow. And that's, again, people like Mike is why I did not want to release my records, because I don't feel I'm a hero compared to people like Manuel's older brother. That dude is a hero. That dude fought some hard battles. Me, I just got lucky because I was smart and I outthought the enemy. So I never had to, you know, bang bang a lot. I just used my brain and planned. So, but yeah, I miss Mike. And his brother anyway, Mike Sandoval, he's now a teacher in Upland. He retired from the military after 20 years of service. He's a sergeant first class. And coincidentally, Mike Sandoval and I, we were soldiers together. Let me show you a picture. Last time I saw Mike. So, I'll show you a picture. So, last time I saw Mike, he and I were both wearing these uniforms. He was in this next, this is Alpha Company right here. The next building over is Bravo. He was in Bravo Company. And we would always be at the same parties and hang out. We were both in the 82nd Airborne as young people. And anyway, he stayed infantry. I went different directions. My career, I was all over the place. And he was, you know, straight frontline fighter infantry guy for a long time. And anyway, as we're both retiring, we both ended up at the same civilian jobs, working for Caliber in the same job in Hawaii for a period of time. And we reconnected and we're talking. It's like, what? You? Holy crap, it's you. I mean, we're all old now, right? Like 20 years later. And it was kind of cool. And so I reconnected with Mike Sandoval. Just an awesome guy. So, and I think I have a picture of Mike Sandoval. It's on my phone, not to post it, but yeah, he's just a good guy. And if you're a student of Mike Sandoval in Upland, I won't mess with that guy. Do your homework. I guarantee you, he's not afraid of nothing. That guy, he's my hero. He's one of my heroes. He's a good friend also. My other hero, one of my biggest heroes, is Mike Sanders. I'm sure you guys read that story. Mike Sanders, he's a janitor now. He took care of our family. He made Christmases happen. You know, you read the story. It's on my Facebook. I'll pull it up here in a second. Mike Sanders, he's my brother's big brother in the Big Brothers Big Sisters program, which is a volunteer program to help disadvantaged kids, you know, with positive male and female role models and help them. Well, this guy, he adopted a whole family. He gave up so much money for us. He took care of us. And just a good guy. Well, anyway, after helping me get in the military, he's another person just volunteered to help me, you know, through this rough time in my life. He knew me when I was like 5, you know. I heard he adopted 3 more kids and raised them up. I mean, I hadn't seen the guy in 20 years. Just an awesome person. And he's a janitor. He's not some, you know, sports star. He's just a janitor, just taking care of people. That's awesome. So anyway, and then there's Mike Sandoval. He's not some sports hero. That guy, he's awesome guy. And now he's a teacher, so he's still giving to his community. He's that intrinsic value, you know, he's got. And he does care. He will bend over backwards to help his kids. I guarantee you, those students are much better off for Mike Sandoval. I wish Mike Sandoval's here in Irvine District so I can work with him again. But he's in Upland. It's about a 40-minute drive from here. Small world. Anyway, I can't find that story. It's somewhere buried on my Facebook. Anyway, Angela, I'm gonna get some more water. Come walk with me. So, in the office. You guys want? I'll give you a tour of it. Things keep freezing. I'm on Wi-Fi. Hey, how are you doing?
Good. How are you?
Doing okay. We got some free food too, if you guys want. We got some Mexican food here. From El Toro restaurant, looks like. I got to eat here, so I was able to do a little more live broadcast than I planned. So it's almost 2 o'clock though. 2 o'clock, I think I'm gonna cut it off. We gotta give you guys a tour of where I'm hanging out.
Excuse me.
So now that I'm retiring, and once the campaign is over, I'll be doing more time hanging out here. Can I have some free food? Yeah, sure, come on over. We're in Irvine, California. So I'll give you guys a tour of the office. And we just had a $500,000 renovation. So here's our office. That's Culver Avenue out there. There's Culver right there. So you come in here and you look at our awesome office. Hey, how's it going? So look, check this out. Check what they're displaying. Look at that. Boom. Now it's live. It's only to worldwide. So this is our new office. So we just did this awesome renovation. So
yeah, it's getting better.
So we got this nice hangout area over here. We had an awesome kickoff party and just a cool place to hang out. Just we have our classes and stuff, weekly meetings, et cetera, et cetera. There's also a second floor, which is quite nice. Yeah, it's not a bad place. And then the owner, he's running for city council, but he has a much harder election than me. I think I'll win on this one. And but there's only 6 candidates for 3 seats. City council is 11 candidates for 2, so the odds are much more difficult. And a school board race is not as nasty, I guess you can say. There's not as much dirty politics. It's more civil because we're all parents and we're all for the same, you know, we're all here for the same reason for our kids. At least I hope. So anyway, let me show you this one. This is the memory of that teacher I told you about. This is him. This is David French. I had him in 7th and 8th grade and throughout high school. And now he wrote a letter to me. He actually says, I didn't do good in my junior high school class, but then, you know, he tells his story that about how he has a picture of me in his front of his school and in the office, because now he's a principal of the school. So I have 2 principals and teachers' endorsement, and I have teachers volunteering to help me, which that's just awesome. You guys are amazing. So I can't quit now. I have to advocate. I have to fight for those people that took care of me, because they're helping me. I asked for the help. I put out the community, and all these people are coming to help me. I even had a parent. He saw a sign. He drove by, saw my sign, and went to this website and donated $100. I was like, wow. Name is Sanjay. He lives in my complex. And I was like, you know, I'm your neighbor, right? And he's like, well, when I came by and I met his family, and it's awesome. You know, just the community is coming together. It's because a lot of people are frustrated and they see someone new with some hope, and we're going to make things a little bit better. But we're still going to maintain doing, you know, the high grades, and that's not going to change. We're going to keep up on that. We're going to keep up on STEM, keep up on academics, and then we're going to take care of little people. We're not going to let kids fall through the cracks. Those at-risk people, it's just, and I want to reach out to them too, because I was one of those at-risk kids, 100%, you know, better music. I also mentioned I'm the youngest, so I have a good understanding, on the pulse of the community. I'm actually getting antsy. I want to go out and knock on doors. I want to go talk to people. But Angela, since you're chatting with me, you know, I'll sit here and ramble on. And you ought to come out here, Angela. It really is a nice place to live. we do have some issues, but like I said, they could be a lot worse. They could be a lot worse. Could be like Los Angeles. They got some heavy mountains to climb. So we're not doing too bad. But there are some things we can improve upon, and we will. And the parents here are very passionate about the schools. I mean, real estate agents were very passionate about the schools as well. Very passionate about the safest city in America title. We're very passionate about safety, education, the nice homes. And you've probably never been here, Angela, but you know, it's just a beautiful place here. It is kind of pricey though. The average home price, I believe, is about $800,000 the last time I checked. Up to $5-6 million at Shady Canyon. It's too cold in Ontario. It is hot, actually. I'm gonna be sweating. And like I said, I got a tan. It's great weather. Orange County has wonderful weather. So if you're wanting a place to stay, to move, I'd say move here. Also, someone, a Korean guy told me that in Korea, they have places to say the best schools, the best place to live is in Irvine. So they're advertising our city in Korean to get Korean immigrants to come here. And why not? It is good. It's funny. I identify with Koreans because my stepmom's Korean. I you know, very familiar with the Korean culture as well. Yeah, 안녕하세요. 니하오. 안녕하세요. 아프카바르. 카무스타카. 비게이츠. 코메에스타. Any other language to speak? Shabbat Shalom. Let's see. Privyet. What's up? Thank you. Anyway, Russian there as well. Dobar dan. Speak Bosnian. Actually, I got to speak Bosnian. I spent 3 months in Bosnia. I almost got lost in a landmine field once in Bosnia, believe it or not. So I took some classes how to speak Bosnian. That was it. I remember how to say, Ja sam vojnik, ja radimo bazi orao. So I'm a soldier and I worked at Camp Eagle Base. Eagle Base in Tuzla. I got, when I was in
Sarajevo, I got lost, and I just see these, and it was a minefield for real. And it wasn't that bad, I just followed the road and got out of there, but I was looking around like, I shouldn't be here in my truck. I was out with nothing but just no body armor, nothing. Parlez-vous français? J'en comprends pas français. Bonsoir. Yeah, forgot, I speak a little French too. I only know bad words in French, like only bad words. It's because I spent time with the French Marines in Cherbourg. I was stationed in Germany, and we went to France to redeploy some troops. Some French troops are going to the North Carolina for some exercises, and I spent a week with the French Marines.
Oh, fair, fair. Yeah, we were door knocking. Yeah, it's going good.
Yeah, we're just hanging out here. They always. I'm the guy that's always talking to my phone. It's just okay. So anyway, Angela, what do you think about a politician using Facebook Live like I am right now to connect with voters and to honestly ask questions? What do you think of it? I wish more of them would do it. And do you have any questions? I'm watching myself on the screen. You can chat, say text hi. Are you watching on your phone? I think it's great pump to be mayor. I agree. I used to do Periscope a lot, and I had up to 2,100 followers, and like anytime I would come on, like 100 people would talk to me. The thing is, they're all across the country, which was great. I had one viewer in Northern California. He donated $100 as well, which was awesome. How cool is that? But I need more targeted, because I do need votes. I need the money, but I need the votes, because the money goes to buy these materials. Like these are 8 cents each. Had about 10,000 of these. Hi, Kim Conte, how are you? About 10,000 of these made. I was in your Periscope follower. You were. That's awesome. That's why there's some Ontario calling me. Hey, Kim, where are you from? Are you from Irvine? So I'll stand from there. If you're from Irvine, I'll stand there 10 minutes. We could talk about Irvine school board race. This is me. I am running for public office. I am asking for your vote, and you can ask me questions directly, and I will honestly answer them. You can get answers from the comfort of your own home, rather than just reading some bio online and looking at some photos or something. You can actually talk to me. I will go back real quick and say I started this like a year ago, working with the district, trying to advocate for increased safety and help with special needs kids. But I was frustrated at the system and felt ignored. So I pushed forward, getting more engaged, trying to make a difference. And I felt like there's hoping I was going to go away. Well, I'm not. I think it should still be Periscope sometimes. I might. I do like the platform a little better. I like how I can turn the phone and there's more people on it. But I need to engage at least the next 40 days and probably beyond with people locally. Periscope is fun because there's always people on Periscope to talk with, but once I build this up, get more friends and more followers, will more people, do you want to keep ISD non-toxic, pesticide free? You were talking about Portola High School. Of course I want. No one wants toxics in high schools. I know that they want to do more testing, what's wrong with more testing? I wouldn't have an issue with that, to make sure it's at acceptable levels. That's my kid's high school you're talking about that they're going to have to go to. So, again, no, I don't want any toxics in the schools. What do you think? I don't think you would want either based on your question. So, did I answer your question? I'll let you type. Anyway, I'll talk about something else. Once I see your response, I'll respond back to you because I want to keep you engaged. So, of course, non-toxic's good. And Kim Conte, I spent 20 years in the military, so I'm with Non-Toxic Irvine. ISTU has now banned Roundup. Yeah, Monsanto type stuff, Roundup Ready seeds, all that. I know. And yeah, the chemicals, you don't need those around bodies. So you know 2,4-D. No, let me look it up though. Agent Orange. My brother got exposed to Agent Orange. Of course, I want Agent Orange. I know that a group you're talking about that keep toxics out, and I totally agree. Keep toxics out. 2,4-D. Look it up real quick. Yeah. Great to hear we have our support. Well, thank you. Yeah, I don't want that on my kids. You know, come, you know. And I was in the military for 20 years. I've seen illegal dumping. I think I'm out for some reason. I've seen illegal dumping with my own eyes. And you didn't, I know who you're talking about. I saw the research. I didn't even really have to look at the research. I've seen dumping, toxic dumping on military bases. And the base has been there since 1943. So continued testing is probably smart. And, you know, I'm not an expert in that. So I don't really want to get too much down the rabbit hole with that. But if you came at me and said, hey, let's do some more testing, I'd say, you know, go ahead, test it. I don't have any issues with that. I don't know who would. Nontox.org for our background. I know, I think I've seen the site. You probably know the same people I do. Sick. I'm going to look it up. Well, anyway, I think the issue is the money, right? Getting more money for that testing and stuff. And I'm okay going toxic. I'll go ahead and I'll fight with the state to get us increased funding to address those issues. I'm trying to get your website. Nontoxicirvine.org. Okay, here's your website right here. Is it right here? That's it right there. So if you're watching this, go to this website, nontoxicirvine.org. I haven't seen this website. I saw a different website. But you know, you don't have to sell this whole thing, but if you want, let's do testing. And again, I would defer to the experts on this, but in a nutshell, if you want to say, let's do testing, okay, got it, no issues. But I would probably rely on people like you and your group and the scientists to, you know, give the specific details. Like, I'm an expert in safety and security. I will argue technical points with anybody and explain the vulnerabilities and what we have to do, like specific details. I don't know all that stuff here, what's acceptable levels and what isn't. So I'll just leave it at that. I hope that satisfies your question.
Good job for putting that on. That's cool.
But I do know that when you have chemicals in your body, it affects your hormones and it's not good. Like bisphenol A's and plastics, you know, like melting plastic in your microwave and eating it in your food is probably not a good idea, right? Your body's not meant to drink plastic. So, seems like it's kind of common sense to me. My 7-6-year-old wants to know what sports you like. Okay, well, when I was in high school, I did wrestling and judo. And like wrestling, like the, not punching, kicking, but judo. Take care. Now I do running. I like to run marathons. Last time, it's been a while since I did a marathon. Hopefully I can do, next year, I can do more running. And I like to lift weights when I have time. I haven't with the campaign. I lifted weights this morning for the first time, which is why I have energy now. This morning I lifted for like 20 minutes before I took my son to school, and I was able to do that. I woke up real early. My wife's still there, and got a quick workout at the gym. And I like to do that. So I'd like to get back into more MMA and martial arts training and boxing. I know maybe it's not what you want to hear, but they're big into football or basketball. I did like baseball for a time being. When I was a little kid, like 8, 9 years old, I did baseball. I really liked baseball. Like, and I was living in Northern California. We liked the San Francisco Giants. I almost said New York Giants. The San Francisco Giants. When the earthquake happened in 1989, the Loma Prieta quake that brought down the Bay Bridge, we were actually outside playing baseball during the World Series in Sacramento. So. Anyway, my reaction is ask where your son goes to school, but don't tell me. I'll message me, because they might go to the same school. Yeah, but kids love baseball. I know I did when I was a little boy. So I want to ask you where your son goes to school, but I don't want you to put that out there, because that's personal information. I could tell you that we were supposed to be in Woodbury, but we have Woodbury displaced. And there's no school buses, which is another issue. We don't have any school buses. If you want a school bus, you have to pay for it. Which is odd. I've never heard that ever before. So, but I have to drive, you know, like 40 minutes, drop on the side of the city, it sucks. Hopefully next year we'll get them into Woodbury School, if we're still living there. I definitely will be staying in Irvine. We would like to buy a house when things get better. I actually spent a lot of my money here on the campaign. I'm driving an older car. I could have bought a new car, but I was like, no, I'll buy a campaign instead. Who does that? You know, who does that? That's, but it just, I couldn't walk away from this. There's problems that I had to fix. And I felt it compelled me to do this and do things maybe I wasn't comfortable doing. You know, I don't want to go to a debate. I don't want to argue with people professionally to get things done, but I felt it's necessary. We have to. And it's for my son. It's for your kids. You know, it's not about some social club or some social status. I could care less. I had all the status I could. I got so many accolades. I had the parades. I had my change of command ceremony. I'll put up photos. I had hundreds of people there, you know, saying how great you are. It doesn't mean anything. We get the intrinsic reward from helping others. That's why I do this. You know, I could tell you some of the best times I had was, getting the awards and stuff I got. Like when I got the award for heroic achievement, which sounds crazy to say that, that felt good. You know, when they said for heroic achievement while serving, da 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 da, Mark Nugent is awarded, blah blah blah. That was great. But anyway, back to the district and back to this. You know, we got issues, but we can fix them. That's the thing, Kim, is we can fix them really easily. We just have to admit there's a problem and then address it. The things we don't like to say that. Melissa Fox just posted in I Grew Up in Irvine. I've never met her, by the way. So anyway, Kim, what part of the city do you live in, if you're still here? You know what you guys should do, Kim? You should tell everybody, all the politicians, that need to live broadcast more. I know one, I'm not going to spend any names. He did live broadcast for like 47 seconds. He did live for 47 seconds. North Irvine. I live near you. My son goes to a school near Portola. I'll just text you here. I'll send you a private message. I'm not going to tell you where my kid goes to school or publicly. Any. Kim Conte. I'll send you a quick private message. You might go to the same school as my kid. Goes to Kim. I don't want to put it out there, and then you don't say a specific school where your kid goes. I just sent you a private message. So there you go. Just let me know if it's the same. So tell all the other candidates to do live broadcasting. One, he did it live for 47 seconds. He turned the camera on him, and he had someone. He was all scripted. Both of my boys do too. Same school? Same school? Cool. Yeah, I looked at your photo. You look familiar. And then someone stole that. They need shade structures. They do. They also, you know that one wall on that busy street? I almost got hit this morning with my son. We need, you know Christine Vu. Anyway, we want to put like a 3-foot hedges, like just hedges, like bushes, 3 foot, like thick, to keep her son from running in front of the street. And, you know, and that's it. That's what we've been advocating for. Like 70 feet. How hard would that be? Keep the kids, at least for supervision, they won't run out in front of traffic and get hit by a car. And also someone removed one of my signs, or three of them. They actually, they pulled it off. I don't know why. Maybe it was a high school kid. Maybe it was, I don't know who did it, but it sucks. And actually spun the special needs parents, donated to my campaign. Really appreciate that. Because each sign is $5. So far, $2,500 in the signs and a bunch of other money. But I just can't quit. I just, and I'll tell you that, Kim, that some of those teachers there talked to me in the condition of anonymity, and they're not happy. We need happy teachers to have happy kids. And I wish more teachers would reach out to me, because I would protect them. They're against fences. No, they're not, Kim. Actually, they're screaming for them. I've talked to at least 100 parents in that school. And my dentist, actually, she has kids that go to school with us. And her and all of her friends, they are very, they want, like, a lot of stuff done. And I'm like, listen, we could do a lot of things. We can do things like give radios, you know. Again, I don't want to talk about all the vulnerabilities here. We can private message me or call me about the parents. No, the parents want safety and security, and we could do it. We're not going to give you just the illusion of security, but real. No, I've talked to Kim. I've talked to thousands of people. I'm going to go door knocking, probably talking to a couple hundred people. I just knock on their door and say, hey, I'm Mark. I'm running for school board. I'd like to ask your vote, and you can ask me any questions if you like. And people are worried about that, but they don't want this illusion fake. They want real, like, real plans, real stuff, like a virtual perimeter around the schools. Like in the mornings when they're dropping off, there should be, everyone should be around there with a radio in their hand, right? Going, everything's fine, we're good. Oh, Johnny twisted his ankle, send an ambulance. You know, small stuff like that. Make sure we challenge strangers. Straight sage structures, I'll fight for that. Why not? Yes, a shade structure is great. We can plant more trees, whatever you recommend. I'm okay with that. But at the end of the day, though, the biggest issue we have right now is communication. Parents are ignored. Teachers are ignored. That's not right. And people just do what they want anyway and just hope you go away. That's what they thought. I was just going to go away. I started talking to the school in September. I was not satisfied instantaneously. I was like, okay, this person doesn't have the answers I need. I immediately went to the district, calling them. I went to the district before San Bernardino happened. I told them things were going to start happening, and it did. After the San Bernardino attack, I was there speaking to them. They just ignoring me, thinking it was just going to be fine. I was like, no, I'm not going to go away. I'm going to keep fighting. And then Christine talked to me about her son, and just fired me up more. And some of the teachers talked to me and said they were worried about safety. They don't feel safe. So just more and more, this just kind of... All right, take care. Appreciate it. Please tell everybody. And I'm going to head off here. I'm going to go campaign the rest of the day. And I really appreciate you listening to me and chatting with me. It says we have a couple other people here chatting with me as well. So if you would like to talk, go ahead and talk. Otherwise, I'm probably going to get off here. I've been by for 30, 40 minutes now. I'm going to go door knock and get some more votes and raise awareness, et cetera, et cetera. And this is how elections are won in locals. In the local election, you have to door knock. Enjoy meeting you at Dale's office. Cool, Tom. Appreciate meeting you too. All right, hope you're an Irvine voter, Tom. Hope you'll people to vote for me. And we do need help with the campaign. So if you want to donate, go to this website, markforirvine.com. Or you can donate on the Facebook page if you guys want to help. Or you guys can, I can give you a big stack of these. You can knock on your neighbor's doors, tell them, hey, join our campaign. If you want to help placing signs out, I'm going to have a few hundred more signs made next week. So if you want to help me put the signs out, it takes a lot of time for that. What worked out best the other day, my neighbor drove me around in his nice BMW, well, fast one too. He would drive and I would jump out and put a sign up. He just drove. And we covered a lot of the north area the other day. It took us like an hour and we had like 50 signs in like 1 hour. That was really fast. Usually takes me like an all day to put that many signs out. I have to jump out of the car myself and jump back in. So he drove me all around. So if you guys want to help me out anyway, or get the word, or share this, like my feed, like my content, and get the word out for vote in November. Also, the absentee ballots go out the 9th of October. They will be being mailed out. So remind everybody to vote and vote for us. Vote for me, nobody else. Just vote for Mark Nugent. And we will get some real change. And you guys can always contact me. My phone number is 949-529-0497. That's 949-529-0497. Or my email is mark.nugent@kw.com. That's mark.nugent@kw.com. Stands for Keller Williams, kw.com. mark.nugent@kw.com. Or you can just direct message me here, and I always have my phone with me. So usually I'll get back to you in about 30 seconds or a minute tops. Unless I'm, of course, doing something else. But I'm very available for you guys. I try to do as much live broadcasting as I can, at least once a day. I guarantee I'll at least do 2 to 3 times a week. And then after I get elected, I will still be doing these things. So you guys can bring up issues you have. If you're a parent, you're a teacher, you can contact me anonymously. If you're a teacher, you don't want, you know, you weren't losing your job or something, and you need some advocacy, or, you know, something's not fair, something's not right, or something needs reported, you can let me know. You can let me know. Either way, I'll help you out. I'll never stop. It's just going to keep going. The district's got to deal with me for at least 11 more years till my son graduates high school. That's what I always joke about. So anyway, guys, I think I'm going to get off here. I really appreciate you guys hanging out with me and all the comments and questions and stimulating discussion. And again, feel free to contact me anytime for any issues you guys have. Or, hey, if you want to buy a house, too, I can help out with that. I do real estate now. All right, take care. Bye.